My students are collecting water samples at a station that we come out to every week. We get a water sample and also measure water chemistry here. The fires that happened last year on Mount Nebo and in the surrounding area were really unique and remarkable because it burned a huge area. Over 200 square miles burned in this watershed. That's very uncommon. That's caused by climate change, by the fact that we used to suppress a lot of these fires so fuels can build up on the mountain. What we've seen since the 1970s is the area of wildfire that burns each year has more than doubled in the western United States. So Utah is on its way towards more larger and more severe wildfires. It's relatively unknown how these large megafires are going to affect stream chemistry and water flow. We purchased these high-frequency water monitoring stations that we've installed at about 24 locations throughout the Spanish Fork watershed. That lets us tease apart how does the wildfire affect how much water moves through the system, how much sediment is moving through the system, and then also what's dissolved in the water.
The questions that we are really interested in right now are how the wildfires will affect the harmful algal blooms in Utah Lake.
Utah Lake is the low point in Utah Valley, and basically all of the rivers and streams flow towards Utah Lake. Utah Lake is suffering from a condition called eutrophication, where you have too much nutrient going into the ecosystem. That causes an overgrowth of algae. The situation is not uncommon. In fact, two-thirds of the world's water bodies now are experiencing harmful algal blooms.
And the reason why that algae gets there is because there are tons of nutrients.
That's because people are everywhere, and wherever we go, we spread nutrients all across the landscape. Then those nutrients wash into aquatic ecosystems. When you look at a river, sometimes you want to judge it and say, if it's clear, it must be great, and if it's muddy or turbid, then it must be in bad condition. But that often is exactly the opposite. When you see a muddy river that's transporting all of that ash downstream, that's not a destroyed ecosystem. That's part of the natural renewal process. So right after the fire event, we've seen a big peak in nutrient concentrations. Those are things like carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus. It is incredible to see how rapidly these ecosystems recover from a wildfire. And the ecosystem is really adapted for this. It's designed to deal with this kind of disturbance. So again, we need to change kind of our expectations. When we see a natural disturbance, it's a chance for the ecosystem to renew itself.